back, people. Mission for today is I have two units to look at. One needs a thermostat. I didn't do any of the diagnosis. I'm just doing the repairs. One has no refrigerant. It's flat. So I'm going to do a leak search. I'm going to start on that one first. Do a leak search. There's a nitrogen. And use the H10 Pro for the first time. Maybe put a little trace gas. Do a leak search. The guy said he think is in the condenser section by the compressor because you see oil residue. So I'm going to search there. Put some nitrogen. And see if I can find it. Repair it. Replace the filter dryer. Pull a vacuum. Hopefully under 500 microns. And that's that. This part is heavy. And I do not have a rope. So I'm thinking about pulling everything up with my extension cord. If not, might just go to Home Depot, not too far from here. Get some rope. Pets. I went on the roof to take a look, and it's hot up there. Got a white roof, but I ain't complaining. Ain't no need to complain about what we signed up for. This elevator got a trick to it. Things say we gotta do one, two, one. Let me go up. Thanks, there go one, two, one. Oh, man. You go to the third floor, you supposed to be some type of code you gotta press. Try this. One, two, one. Some help. The access to the elevator. I got the code. I'm sorry, I forgot the code. It took me to the second floor. I hit 3, 2, 3.
Did you hold the button down?
I probably didn't.
Yeah, I think that's what it got you.
Yeah.
That scared me. Yeah, can you hold this down?
It? Mm-hmm.
Until you hear the beep?
Okay, yeah, that's what I didn't do.
Okay. Yeah.
Okay, good. So hold it down, hit a beep, do 3, 2, and then 3.
Yep.
Okay. There's a rope down here somewhere. Water. No rope. So I'm gonna go to Home Depot and get a rope. But I'm gonna think I'm gonna go ahead and get started, put some nitrogen in there. I think that's all I need. Nitrogen. The gauges. Got tangled up, look like. There we go. I'm about to go get a rope. So I don't want to have to buy a rope because I got like 4 in the house. I It might just be my rope today. Throw one in my truck. All right, this the corporate right here. I think so anyway. Say number 7. Circuit 1. Should be this one. Twisted drive. Got no rope with me, it's sad, ain't it? So I do make it do what it do. need my veto pack. It's like, sit down. Pressures on both of the liquid lines, socket 1 and 2. So I can label socket 1 and 2 filter dryer. Be circle one now, it's flat. I gotta make sure this R22, it could be 410A. I didn't even look before I bring it up. Quick start. Alright. So this is my suction line hooked up to this, must be circuit 1 right here. Let's see what we got on this other liquid line. Yeah. So this gonna be circuit 2 right here. Sure, right here. Hook up the suction. One flat. All right, that's flat. So this is number 2, this is number 1, because we don't want to mess up and take that spray to vibe out of there, and I mean take that filter out of there, because I have before got these two lines mixed up, and one circle with low, one had refrigerant in there, and I braid this and refrigerant go everywhere. So now, since that happened, I always double check to make sure. That might have happened to me twice too. That's why I like when they do put access port. Yeah. All right, that circuit there is flat. So I'm gonna put some nitrogen and some trace gas and make sure I get the right refrigerant. Because if this 410A, I don't have any. That ain't the tag. Oh, it should be on the compressor section also. Ba-da-ba-ba, ba-da-ba-ba. Operating suction 65 discharge. I guarantee this R22 with those low pressures. 85 degree day should be 68 and 229. Gotta be R22. Yep, mineral oil. Let me see. present. Let's see. I mean, it gotta be R22 though with the pressure. Yeah, it gotta be R22. I could call. It looks like I see a serial number, model number on here. I could call and make sure, but older these units is, it gotta be R22. Trace gas in there. That's zero PSI, huh? I need to put some in there. Start out with 100. 71, 72 PSI. I hear something. Linux notorious for leaking up in here. I don't think this may be the original compressor, but I don't know if that's factory well right there or what. This should be fun. Usually put the gas in first. I should have went on and put some trace gas in there. Let me see if I can get something in there with the nitrogen. And I hear something. Thanks. I couldn't hear what 70 PSI when I put that 150 in, or 140. Yeah, I thought I heard something though. Hit that with the XOI. Yeah. Oily. Circuit one was flat. I got 140 PSI of nitrogen. It's a lot of residue on this discharge line. You can hear it. Let me see if I can locate the leak. I feel like it's right here. Nice little cut right there. On this back side. That shouldn't be too hard to get back there. Let me see. Wish I can cut that whole thing just running right here. But, try to put some solder on it. Got soft copper. Alright, HVAC people, I'm going to get my torches set up. Release all this, replace that filter dry, and leak check it again. All right, if you get ready to try to repair this leak, it's right behind here somewhere. I cannot see it, I can only feel it. It shouldn't be too
shouldn't be too hard, but it's not gonna be the easiest either.
Try to heat that pipe up. Feel like it two cuts, one right here and one right there. Try to heat the back between those two marks. Get another flint.
working blind, but I don't know if I got it or not. I hope I do. Hit it one more time, then check. All I'm doing is heating that backside and letting it
wrap around.
See how the camera got hot. All right. That filter dry next, and then I'm gonna leak check. Go ahead and replace this filter dryer. Glove or some fire screw. It's a channel lock.
Yeah. I don't have my gloves. Could have made it a little more prettier. A little trick, some people have all that smut like this. They keep all that smut from going anywhere. If you brazing inside a building or in the attic or like in a cooler or something, you don't want all that smut going everywhere. So you just turn this until you kind of hear and open your oxygen slightly, and you'll have a nice blue flame without all that smut going everywhere. Titties right there, as long as it don't leak. And I try to heat away from the flare sometime, because that solder like to go towards coal, so it kind of suck in to the fitting. I do a leak check. I got that down there, I'm not sure. Alright, we're at zero, I'm gonna start over, reset it. Got about three in there because I looked these back up. Cause I'm purging that nitrogen. I know my leak, it I ain't gotta put too much in there. Very bottom down here. I got some of it. Alright. We're gonna get it this time. Oh.
to go run and get a bottle of water because I don't want it to get too hot. That's what I'm scared of too. Run and get a bottle of water. It's a big blue.
All right. Try this again. Got me some water this time. I was kind of scared to overheat or burn something down. Throw me a little water back here. I didn't have my camera setting on that thing. It was getting hot. If there's a leak at the bottom around there, I need to see if I can get some solder on there. Still missing a little piece on this back side right here. think it's a little pee. Wish I'd came down a little far. Yeah, right there on that back. Sorry. I should have used more solder. Bear with me, I'm gonna get it. gotta be in there. Be an easy fix, but it's hard to get back there. Wish I had the right tools, it'd be a little easier too. I ain't got my mirror with me. I don't think so. Gotta hurry up and get my backpack back. All right, let's try this thing again. Got it that time. Got it that time. I think it was like two cuts in there, two or three. In there as I can and let it hold about 11:30. Pull the vacuum, place that thermostat, charge it up, call it up there. Got 140 some PSI nitrogen. If it were leaking, I would be able to see it. See if I get 150 in there, hold it. Thank you. right, got 151. Clean up a little bit, take my torches down, take the nitrogen down, and I'm gonna do a pressure hold test. Let's do 10 minutes. We're gonna do 3%. No, I don't even want that. I'm gonna do about, I don't know if you can see this, I'm gonna do, that's 1.6% in 10 minutes. So, we're about 151. If I lose more than 1.6%, I should say fail or pass. All right. I had to run to the truck because the memory card was full. I'm at 423 microns. That probably about 30-35 minutes though. I'm gonna go ahead and charge her up. We're gonna put about 5 pounds in the head of start. Alright, so what I wanna do is make sure these are closed and we're gonna go ahead and pull a vacuum on the hoses. Let it go back down real quick. All I'm doing is pulling the vacuum on these. These had a little air in it and back now, fast. I should have just did it on one, on this one right here. My liquid, that's what I'm gonna charge it. You pull that back down real fast. So if you pull it under 500 microns, that's going to guarantee you don't have any leaks or any moisture in the system. And you can kind of constantly walk away from it knowing that you don't have any leaks. Thank you. I'm just gonna get it under 7. I'm gonna go ahead and isolate it. The vacuum. Charge it up. I was already at 420 something, so I'm pretty sure I don't have any leaks. I'm gonna go ahead and isolate this valve and isolate this one. Now I'm not putting that vacuum no more. Now I'm just because you don't want this to rise above 1,000 in 5 minutes. That'll guarantee you don't have any leaks. If you start rising fast, you know you got a leak. If you're rising, but it's going slow, you got moisture in the system. But I think we good to go. A lot of times it shoot up and then it come back down. But this one here, it's good to go. So all I'm gonna do is charge it through my liquid line. So I'm gonna open this up. Already purged it once. Purge. And look at my scale. Open up the liquid. Put about 5 pounds in. Micron gate. Forgot about that. Should be alright though. Remember, I gotta put Schrader valves back in two of them. And put the Schrader valve in this one. This is the yellow jacket. About 5 pounds there. Thick, good, and tight. So I'm gonna close this. This one. Should be able to use this. Should be the same, man. That just better one. I'm gonna use a yellow jacket to put it in there.
to hold it down my thumb like that and kind of twist. You can feel the pressure. Okay, I think I got it on now. Test if you got it or not. You can kind of open it up a little bit. See, I don't got that one. I think I got the bottom one though. But actually, I think I do got it. I just opened it up. This. I got refrigerant in this line. That's why I did that. So I think I got it in there. I got 5 point. Almost 6 pounds of refrigerant in there. So I'm gonna go ahead and fire up. Let's see what we're working with. Get this out the way. Ba-da-ba-ba. I'm gonna go ahead and take these off. Hopefully I got it in there right. So no, I got that one. Straighter in that one. I wasn't sure about this one, but I think I got it. Still be a little refrigerant in there, huh? I know I got it. I'm gonna take this off. Yeah, just a little refrigerant in there. There we go. Something back there so that won't happen again.
Man, it's a lot of oil in there. The scenes of them in the movie theater. Where it all goes down. Will Smith new movie.
I went on ahead, went to lunch. Gotta wait for that unit to call, but I'm gonna have to make it come on myself.
Got 5 pounds in there. Probably gonna be a little low. For the target sub cool of 10. Let me see this. I'm gonna skip these delays. There we go. So it should go. It's wire one. But circuit one. Should kick on, then the compressor should kick on.
That's the fan.
Now I go Y1 is my compressor.
Still real low. We was at about 35 PSI. Went on and started charging it, but a low pressure switch won't shut it off and go in an alarm. I'm gonna put about 8 pounds in there and then check it again. We're gonna need at least 9 pounds in there though. I'm gonna put about 9. I'll put 8. I'm gonna do a target subcool at 10. Let it run for about 5 minutes before I add any more refrigerant. Right now I got 8 pounds. Really supposed to charge them with both circuits up and running. 8.4, 9.4, and 9.1. Subcooled at 1, so it's still low. We charge it up as a gas right now. All right, there goes circuit 2. About 10 pounds in there. Might stop at 9. 480, 482, 478. Turn that temp to 80. Nice and cold. That sub cooler about 8. Got 52 on the supply. Air temperature. Suction 62, a little more in there. System shouldn't hold no more than 12 pounds. About 10 and a half pounds. I think I'm putting too much more in there. It's about 64 over 245. I'm gonna call that good. Subcooling at 4. I'd like to get that up to 8. About 92 going in, 113, so about 21 degree temperature difference on the condenser. Got 10.7 pounds. We're 64. $2.45. That's good enough for me. I don't really know what area it serves. On my return, it's kind of hot down there.
to see nothing up here. Got about 4 degrees sub cooling. I'm putting a little more in there.
Maybe put about 11 pounds. See if that bring that sub cool up a little bit. Put 11 pounds in there and call it a day.
I'm fine number 8. Need to change the thermostat. I don't know if I'm... This one good to go here. But I got about 50 on the supply temperature. Leak repaired. That's a wrap. That's a leak repair from start to finish. Charge unit. And we out.